Okay, this sermon is entitled Learning the Bible. I'd like to open up with prayer and then with a few verses. All right, dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners, I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Psalm 59 reads, Deliver me from mine enemies, O my God, defend me from them that rise up against me. Deliver me from the workers of iniquity, and save me from bloody men. For lo, they lie in wait for my soul, the mighty are gathered against me, not for my transgression, nor for my sin, O Lord. Now lots of people out there, especially churchgoers, will follow along in their Bible with the pastor as he reads, and they might even, you know, make some annotations or take some notes. But a lot of people are not really reading the Bible in a way that's, you know, academic or scholastic, or in a way that's going to help them learn God's Word. They're just reading it in sort of like a perfunctory way. And I want to go over some verses that explain why it's important that we actually learn what the Bible is teaching. So turn over to 1 Peter chapter 3. 1 Peter chapter 3, and let's take a look at verse 15. See, we may deal with people out there that have questions about, you know, why we believe in God or why we believe the Bible is God's Word. And the spectrum ranges anywhere from, you know, the unlearned, unsaved atheist to maybe people that are saved and they just don't understand a certain doctrine, like, for instance, eternal security. And as believers in Christ, as we grow, and I'm going to get into that point in a minute here, we need to be able to give an answer to such people. And it reads in verse 15, it says, But sanctify the Lord God in your hearts, and be ready always to give an answer to every man that asketh you a reason of the hope that is in you with meekness and fear. So he tells us right there that we need to start learning God's word. And let's take a look at a verse that talks about growth. We need to learn God's word in order to grow. And we need to grow because if a person is not growing spiritually, they're going to remain a babe in Christ. And it's going to affect their lives. And a person perhaps will make the wrong decisions in life based on, you know, how mature they are as a believer. So turn back to 1 Peter chapter 2, and it says in verse 1, Wherefore, laying aside all malice, and all guile, and hypocrisies, and envies, and all evil speakings, as newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby, if so be ye have tasted that the Lord is gracious. Now, spiritual growth does not happen through osmosis. And what I mean by that is it doesn't happen when a person just lazes around and does nothing. Now, you could say it happens osmotically through the Word, okay, because the Word of God is alive, and that's why it tells us that we need to desire the sincere milk of the Word, that ye may grow thereby. Now, obviously, people grow, and they grow up physically through proper nutrition, through proper dieting. And just like we need milk and other physical comestibles to grow, we need God's word to grow spiritually. Now, let's take a look at another reason why we should grow and we should learn God's word is so that we can refute false doctrine. Turn back to John chapter 8. See, all false doctrine is God's word being molested or being vitiated through the teachings of a devilish, you know, bedeviled, demonized false prophet. So what does it take to combat this type of teaching? It takes the truth. And we see this concept in verse 32 of John chapter 8. It says, And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Now, notice the key word, know. When we know the truth, when we're learning the truth, it'll set us free. So now, let's take a look at one more verse and one more reason why we should learn God's word. Learning God's word as a believer will give us peace. And we see this concept in 2 Peter. 2 Peter chapter 1, let me read the first two verses, and it reads, Simon Peter, a servant and an apostle of Jesus Christ, to them that have obtained like precious faith with us through the righteousness of God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. Now, notice it says that we can have grace and peace be multiplied. Okay, but it's only through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. Reading the Bible and learning the Bible will give us peace. And think about it. Just imagine you have some unsaved person out there who's lost and they're afraid they're going to go to hell. They have no peace. They're living in a constant state of consternation and trepidation, and then all of a sudden they see salvation and it brings them peace. Now imagine somebody who's saved but who lacks assurance. And they have this constant dubiety going on. where they're not sure if they're saved or not because of some stupid unsaved Arminian teaching salvific loss. Or maybe it's some stupid unsaved Calvinist teaching that you have to persevere to the end and that you can't know for sure that you're saved and that it's by works. Okay, that would cause a person to be very apprehensive. But see, as they learn God's word and they learn that it's all grace and that it's not of works and that you don't have to persevere to the end and that you can't lose your salvation and that you're eternally secure, what happens is you get peace and the peace will multiply. And it's through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. So that's why it's so important to learn God's word, because God's word is alive. God's word has an effect on our lives. So I'm encouraging people to read the Bible and to study the Bible and to learn it. And that's all I have. Dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners. I ask all this in Jesus' name.